Hey everybody, my name is Jamini Sabrina and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be talking about how to be a godly woman in a modern world. As every day goes by, we see new trends that come and go, and as women we often get caught up in those trends, whether it's lifestyle, technology, beauty, fashion, whatever it is, we often get caught up. Oftentimes, these things aren't as godly as they seem. I'm going to be giving you guys 3 tips on how to be a godly woman in a not so godly world and how you guys can achieve it and remain true to yourselves and to God. So without further ado, let's dive right into the video. And before you go, sis, if you're not subscribed, then what are you doing? We need you to be subscribed to this channel. Give that big old thumbs up to let me know that you guys like this video and comment down below for future video references. So now, without further ado, let's get right into the video. So tip number one, if you see me looking down, it's because I've written these tips down in my journal. And well, to remember what I wrote down, I'm going to be reading it off of my journal. So tip number one is, above all, be saturated in the Word. This is the most important on how to remain godly in this modern world that we're living in. We must stay true and we must stay in tune with God's word. Let's think of ourselves and our mind as sponges. If we get a clean sponge and we submerge it in dirty, filthy water, then what becomes of the sponge? It usually absorbs all that dirt and, well, it's no longer pure. But what if we grab the clean sponge and we submerge it into clean water? Then what happens? It remains pure because the water isn't filthy. So that is how we should think of ourselves as humans. We are sponges and we absorb our surrounding. If we surround ourselves with things and we saturate ourselves with things that are not based in God's word, then we'll kind of become sort of like that thing. So what I'm trying to say is we must saturate ourselves in God's word. When we read God's word, we become saturated in his purity. It's very important to take that time of the day, whether it's 5 minutes, 10 minutes, an hour, just take your Bible and read it. Every day there's something new that we can learn. God is preparing something new to saturate our mind and our spirit. So, tip number one is, above everything else, prior to social media, prior to fashion, prior to beauty, prior to any other worldly thing that can consume our time, let's saturate ourselves in his word. Remember, we absorb our surroundings. We absorb what we see with our eyes, what we hear with our ears. So that's why we must do things that satisfy God, that's true to his word, and that satisfies our soul. Tip number two, a godly woman uses God's standards for beauty. This is a tip that's been very true to my heart because I found myself sometimes comparing myself to others, maybe going through Instagram, through Facebook, and wanting to look like a certain way because that is what society portrays. But instead, God wants us to be true to his beauty standards. God made us all perfect in our image. It's very easy to get consumed and to get wrapped up and caught up into looking a certain way. I remember when I was much younger, in high school, they used to not bully me, but make fun of me because of how my lips are. My lips are a little bit more thick than other girls or other people that they usually see. And I would be so insecure about that. But as I came and I studied the Bible and prayed about it, God showed me that I am perfect in his sight. He doesn't want me to compare myself to others or to feel bad about somebody saying something negative about me. He put positive thoughts in my head so that I can love myself. 1 Peter chapter 3 and verse 4 states, "But let your adorning be the hidden person of the heart, with the imperishable beauty of a gentle and quiet spirit, which in God's sight is very precious." God focuses on our spirit. He doesn't focus on our outer appearance. He doesn't focus on the hairstyle we have, on the size of our waist, on the size of our feet. He doesn't focus on the makeup we're wearing, but he focuses on our pure hearts. So the beauty standard, the basic beauty standard that a godly woman should have in a modern world is to focus your beauty on being pure and having a quiet heart. A loud woman or a woman that's in trend with everything isn't the most godly woman. But whether we should focus on, as I said before, on standards that please God. God focuses on our spirit and our soul, while men and women focus on our outer appearance. But that is not what God wants us to do. God would like for us to guard our hearts, clean our hearts, have a pure heart. He doesn't state to have a pure outfit or a pure beat on your face or a pure weave or a pure hairstyle. He says to have a pure heart. So tip number three, and this is the last but not least, is we choose godly role models and friends. Titus chapter 2 verses 3 to 4 tells us, older women likewise are to be reverent in behavior, not slanderers or slaves to much wine. They are to teach what is good and to train the young women to love their husbands and children. This one is very, very important also. In the world we live in, I like to say that quote because it's the world we're living in now. We oftentimes too get caught up into wanting this big old friend group and this big old squad, and we forget what the true intention of friendship is. As women, we must find other women to have a friendship with that empowers us, that helps us to get closer to God. Not only friends to go out and take a selfie in the mirror with, but friends that can teach us something. As we just read that scripture, it says that older woman gives us advice. I'm not saying every older woman is the right person to give you an advice, but I am saying that a godly older woman can be the person to give you the right advice. Not only are they older, but they are much wiser. If you don't have a friend, then I advise you to maybe find a spiritual leader, a church member, somebody that'll help you, that you can sit down and speak with, and this person can teach you something that maybe you don't know. My spiritual leader or my mentor or the person I often lean onto is my mom. She is a very godly woman. She's been serving God all of her life. We were brought up and raised up in a godly home, and I thank God for that, because that is why I feel like I am so grounded in the word, because my mom put in that effort. My mom, she is somebody that I can go to whenever I have anything to speak about, and she's just somebody that I'm comfortable to talk with, and I know she's always going to give me the best advice. So I advise you that in this modern world, find friends that are not going to saturate you in the things of the world, but friends that are going to build you up, help you to be a better person spiritually, emotionally. Friends play a huge part in our lives because they are the ones that we spend most of our time with. Whatever those friends say to you oftentimes can benefit you or can affect you. So that's why I'm telling you to be wise in choosing your friends, because they can be the ones that can often lead you to better things in life. If they are godly women such as you are, then trust me, that friendship will be forever, because they have basically the same intentions as you. So, those are the three tips that I've brought to ladies today on how to be a godly woman, or how to remain a godly woman in a modern world. So, remember, if you like this video and you'd love to see more, don't forget to subscribe down below, give me a big old thumbs up, comment for more videos, and follow me on all of my social medias that are linked down below in the description box. So guys, that is it for today. Stay tuned for a brand new video, maybe this week or next week. And thank you guys for watching. Bye, ladies.